young, kid, scrappy little loudmouth kid that just bullies people just on the fact that they just don't care.
Right.
Right? That's a rare breed. Most bullies, they feel like they can physically win and therefore they can mentally abuse people. A bunch of self-confidence and you're not being humble. And if you're being too humble, then you don't have self-confidence. So a good analogy of this, of course, what we were just talking about is jiu-jitsu, because when you start jiu-jitsu, and we'll turn this into a metaphor for life, but when you start jiu-jitsu, you very quickly learn, number one, that you can get beat, that you're not everything that you thought you were, right? And at the same time, you start to gain confidence. I mean, it makes you more confident because you realize that as you have knowledge, it's things that other people don't know. And so it's the same thing with life, because if you're in life and you step out into the arena, right, you're going to realize that you don't know everything. That's something you're going to realize. And the more that you realize that you don't know everything, the more it humbles you, but also in a reverse way actually makes you more confident, because now you're gaining knowledge because you are stepping into the arena. So it's like with jiu-jitsu, when you spar and you roll, you're going to get tapped, yes, but the more you do it, the more confident you get. And the more you accept the fact that you don't know everything, you don't, like the question before, like, what are you embarrassed about? Why would you be embarrassed in the sport? Don't be embarrassed. Go there and get tapped out. Good. You're learning, you know? And that's what you have to do in life. If you want to gain humility and you want to gain self-confidence in life, you have to get on the mat.
Whether it be in your personal or professional life, many of us suffer from a lack of self-confidence. What can you do to build yourself up so you can take anything down? While it may seem counterintuitive, self-confidence goes hand in hand with humility. The more you realize you don't know, the less confident you may become. But for everything you don't know comes an opportunity to learn. And as you are able to learn, the more confident you can become that you have gained knowledge that not everyone possesses. Go out and put yourself in situations where you may not feel comfortable. Learn what you can and leave knowing that you have grown yourself as a person. The secret to confidence is that there is no secret. Read a book, practice a new hobby, or learn a new skill. No matter what it is that you do, every moment in which you are discovering something within yourself is a moment that you are building yourself up. Go out and do something hard to challenge yourself and stand up straight, knowing that you have achieved something. But no matter what, don't quit. Keep learning and moving and stay humble, knowing that you haven't learned everything yet. Confidence isn't completely about your mental state, it's physical as well. Join a martial arts club, exercise, and work out so that you are prepared for the very real dangers that may come your way. When you are prepared to defend yourself or others if need be, you will experience self-confidence on an entirely different level. Open your mind and prepare your body for whatever comes your way, and confidence will come with it.
You want to increase your confidence. I'll tell you what I think. What you do if you want to increase your confidence is you do jiu-jitsu. You work out, you get stronger, you read, and you study, and you learn, and you get smarter. And then you practice speaking, and you practice speaking so that you can become more articulate, and then you practice some more, and then you do hard things, things that are challenging, things that are tough, and then you get tougher. You don't quit. That's what you do. And then you stand up straight with your head high and your chin up and your chest out, and at the same time you also stay humble because you don't know everything, and there are people that are better than you are at some things. People that are smarter than you, and they're stronger than you, and faster and more athletic than you, and they have more money, and they got better looks, and they're funnier. But all that is okay. I guess it's a little bit of a softball for me to throw this question at me, because you know what I'm going to say. Get your kid into jiu-jitsu. Get your kid into jiu-jitsu immediately. Get them in there and let them start to learn what it's like to deal with people physically. And it will build up their confidence. And it won't be a false confidence. It'll be a real confidence, because they will know how to handle themselves. Mm-hmm. They will have people that are trying to take them down to the ground and trying to choke them. And they will learn to stop that from happening. And they will learn to do it to other people when warranted. So that's how you prevent bullying, in my opinion. You also get him to start doing pull-ups, push-ups, dips. You get him to do a little bit of boxing, maybe even a little Muay Thai. I'll tell you, at our gym, over the years, we've probably had half a dozen kids that have come in specifically because they were getting bullied at school.
Mm-hmm.
And every one of those cases, within 3 months, 4 months, maybe 6 months at the outset, the parents are coming to me and saying, he's not getting bullied anymore. And sometimes there's that incident where I've had a few students that have, you know, and these are kids are, you know, 10 years old, getting picked on. And all of a sudden they start training jiu-jitsu. And then one day they choke out the bully and they never get picked on again. And they're confident and they're not jerks about it. They become defenders because they know what it's like to be bullied. So they don't like to see other people get bullied. So I would say, you know, get your kids into jiu-jitsu if they're getting bullied. And it will not only teach them to prevent themselves from being bullied, it will prevent them from becoming a bully because they'll recognize what it's like and what the power of physical intimidation is, and they will not like it.
Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe for more content.